Okay, so we're ready to go, and we need to know what our project is, what our requirements are before we start working on our project. So for this course, we're going to use the UX Apprentice site as the basis for our requirements. Now, UX Apprentice is an introduction to user experience design that we created with Teresa Neal's help. Teresa is a user experience design consultant who has written two O'Reilly books on mobile design and design patterns. And she used this case study for a client in the Austin, Texas area. It was a restaurant that served Japanese casual food. And with this as the basis for this site, we have a look at some of the user research that was done, the strategy work, and the actual design. You'll see a lot of the user research that was done, stakeholder interviews are referenced here, as well as customer research to see what the flow through the restaurant is. And you can look at some of the tasks that were performed to gather this information. And from there, a set of documents were created, personas to describe who the customers were, customer journey maps, which described their experience going through the restaurant and ordering, and what some of the pain points were or the difficult parts of the service. And if we scroll down further in the page, we'll see a little bit more information about what the client is looking for in terms of serving the customer better. So you can open up the personas, for instance, and see the description of the types of customers of the restaurant and what kinds of things they're looking for when they go and order food and how they experience the service there. So personas are one type of document that helps to inform the decision-making process when thinking about the design. And then there's also a diagram of the journey map, which describes all the touch points as a customer is going into the restaurant, ordering, all the way through to leaving the restaurant. And there's a little happiness indicator at the top, and you see the points where improvement can be made. And this is the area that we're going to be looking at in terms of what we can provide as an app to improve the experience with the restaurant. So if we jump through to the strategy section, you see more tasks that were performed to help come up with a concept for what the web app should do. And in this case, we want to just jump to the storyboard, which really describes the ideal situation for what this app should provide in terms of improving the experience. And the whole goal here is really just to get customers out of the long lines and worrying about, or getting blocked by customers in front of them who are having a difficult time or a long time trying to figure out what to order, and get the customers seated where they're going to be served and where they're going to eat so that they can skip the more painful parts of the process. So this storyboard kind of just describes that ideal scenario. And this is really the basis for the design concept. And we're going to be using this to describe and define what we're going to be building in the interface for our web app. So this is the basis for what we're building in the wireframes for this course. And you can use this as your project brief as well to create your own project, or you can use your own product idea to create your own wireframes. But for the course, we're just going to use this concept to just keep moving forward with our project. Okay, so now that we have an idea of what we're going to be building, next up, let's look at the key concepts for using Balsamiq.